On January 1st, 1863, at the height of the American Civil War, President Abraham Lincoln issued Proclamation 95, an executive order that would come to be known as the Emancipation Proclamation, portions of which read as follows. I, Abraham Lincoln, President of the United States, by virtue of the power in me vested as Commander-in-Chief of the Army and Navy of the United States, in a time of actual armed rebellion against the authority of the government of the United States, do order and declare that all persons held as slaves within the rebellious states are henceforth and shall be free. And upon this act, sincerely believed to be an act of justice, warranted by the Constitution, upon military necessity, I invoke the considerate judgment of mankind and the gracious favor of Almighty God. With this proclamation, the legal status of more than 3.5 million people in the rebellious Confederate states changed from enslaved to free. However, as the authority of the United States government was not acknowledged by those states, this freedom was contingent upon the victory of the Union Army as they continued to push forward into Southern territory. No longer was the war simply about preservation of the Union, but rather a Union Army advancing to set other men free. With every victory won, every county and state reclaimed, those held in bondage behind enemy lines were declared permanently free. Some stayed where they were and worked the same jobs they had previously worked, now as waged workers rather than slaves. Some fled north to pursue their freedom without the fear of reprisal from their former masters, and nearly 200,000 newly freed men, making up 10% of the Union Army by war's end, took up arms with the Union to participate in purchasing the freedom of their brothers and sisters with their very lives. The war would rage on for another 2.5 years before finally accomplishing the goal of the Emancipation Proclamation. On June 19th, 1865, 65 days after President Lincoln's life was stolen by an assassin's bullet, Union troops under the command of Major General George Gordon Granger reclaimed Galveston, Texas, the final holdout of the Confederate States, and declared all slaves in that city free. This date would become known and celebrated by the Texas population as Juneteenth, and it is the oldest known organized celebration of the abolition of slavery in the United States. But the work of freedom was not yet done, for though the Emancipation Proclamation declared an end to slavery in the Confederate States, it did not in the slave states that had remained loyal to the Union, namely Delaware, Kentucky, Maryland, and West Virginia. Of those states, Maryland and West Virginia had outlawed slavery of their own accord at the state level during the war, but Delaware and Kentucky had not. Those held in these states were freed with the ratification of the 13th Amendment to the Constitution, which abolished chattel slavery nationwide on December 6th, 1865. And finally, the last slaves present in the United States were freed when those held by the Choctaw Indians who had sided with the Confederacy during the war were released in 1866. In June of 2021, June 19th was declared a national holiday to celebrate the emancipation that had finally removed the evil of human slavery from the United States and extended the promise of our Declaration of Independence to all. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, and that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that are among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. So today, in 2023, we as a church stand in agreement with the freedoms that have been provided for all people in our great nation. And at the same time, we as Christians know that Jesus is the only one who provides ultimate freedom, and he is the one that unifies all of us together as his people. Paul reminds us in Galatians, "For you are all children of God through faith in Jesus Christ. And all who have been united with Christ in baptism have put on Christ like putting on new clothes. There are no longer Jew or Gentile, slave or free, male and female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. And so, to mark this day, as Martin Luther King Jr. said, I will say to all of you, from every mountainside, let freedom ring. And when we let it ring in every village, in every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up the day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestant and Catholic, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, thank God Almighty, we are free at last.